It's time to open a browser window. It's time to put on your favorite pants. Log into Twitter, put your headphones on, and dance, dance, dance. Block out the world for 65 minutes or more. Put a sign on your office door. This DoubleClicks Live for this month is about to start. About to start now. DoubleClicks, DoubleClicks, DoubleClicks Live. It's a free show and you don't have to drive. Sing along, meet the guest. It's almost time for DoubleClicks, 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 DoubleClicks Live. Hello, welcome to DoubleClicks Live. We're the DoubleClicks. I am a bro and this is... Beaker!
I am working hard in the lab on my math.
Day and night. Scientists work hard to develop this content for you. Our special guest this month is Joseph Scrimshaw.
Yay!
We will be playing lots of songs that were requested on the Facebook event for this event. Facebook. And we are excited about it. Yeah, are we, Aubrey?
Yes, we're so excited.
In real life, my name is Angela. This is Aubrey.
Hello.
And we're a band called the Doubleclicks. Thanks for joining us. And we're just gonna play some songs.
Let's play the songs.
That's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna do a Paula Tompkins impression the entire time. Is that okay with everybody?
Yay!
All right, shut up.
We're having a good time. We're so excited to be here doing the live stream with you people.
It's been a very exciting few days because we launched our Kickstarter.
Yeah.
Last week?
How has time gone by so far? Wow. It's been more than 7 days.
I mean, in less than a year. I don't know. For the new album that we're putting out called Love Problems.
Love Problems. Problems and love.
And, yep. And it's great. Let me check in with the chat.
Checking in with the chat. How's the chat doing?
The Kaplar says today is a glorious day for science.
Science!
There's so many people. Hi, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Oh, hi. So, I will say this. If anybody has any questions or wants to talk about the Kickstarter or the new album, feel free to leave them in the chat. And I will try to see them.
Trying.
If there's anything pressing, I don't know. Jonathan Gould has my phone number. He can text me. I didn't set the system up very well. But I'm watching. So, we'll try to answer any questions. We're going to go ahead and get it started with the music, though, because that's what we're here for.
Yeah.
With a song requested by a whole bunch of people, including Angie from Eugene, which is a song about letting people love things and loving the things that you love. Sometimes you can feel like you're not allowed to love the things you love because people make fun of them or you. But we think that enthusiasm is a positive trait.
Yes.
And that's what this song is about. All right, hit it, Aubrey. I like to eat toast with jam. You like to eat eggs and ham. And if you're in, we can be friends, cause I don't have a problem with ham. I like to wear sweaters and skirts too. I like to do just what I want to. And if you don't like what I do with my life, well, that's great, cause I didn't ask you. This is my jam. This is my jam. This is my toast. This is my knife. And this is my jam. This is my jam. This is my jam. This is my song. This is my life. And this is my jam. I'm gonna do this if you don't wanna do this. I'm gonna find somebody who wants to do this. Cause I'm a person and you are a person. You should want what you want long as nobody's hurting. You're not gonna tell me the songs I should write. And you're not gonna tell me my clothes are too tight. Cause I'm gonna love doing all my own stuff. And that love's gotta come from inside. This is my jam. Crank up that track, Aubrey. This is my jam. This is my toast. This is my knife. And this is my jam. Yeah. This is my jam. This is my jam. This is my song. This is my life. And this is my jam. I like to be eating breakfast with people that I like, with no one telling me the things they think I should do with my life. And like John Green tells us to imagine others complexly, I won't judge you, cause what you like has nothing to do with me. I'd like to be eating breakfast with people that I like, with no one telling me the things they think I should do with my life. And like John Green tells us to imagine others complexly, I won't judge you, cause what you like has nothing to do with me. Alright, everybody. This is my jam. This is my toast. This is my knife. And this is my jam. This is my jam. This is my jam. This is my song. This is my life. And this is my jam.
DFTBAs from the chats.
Wait. Oh, no. I don't know. Oh, it's this. Yes. Okay. Yeah. I was like, wait, that's it's not just. Yes.
Yes.
Woohoo.
Hi, everybody. Look at all these nice people. Hello.
Nope. It's not that.
Angie's in the chat. Enthusiasm. Yay.
Thanks for requesting songs, everybody.
All right. We've got our first question. Which is a Kickstarter-related question.
Yeah.
Are there going to be pins available as add-ons or after the Kickstarter? Great question. So, if you don't know, we are running a Kickstarter right now for our album Love Problems. And one of the rewards are these amazing enamel pins that say Women Know Math and Sensitive Badass, which are names of two of the songs on the album. If you want more of those pins, they are not going to be an add-on per se, but we will have them available for purchase after the Kickstarter, and there will be updates about it. We can't make an add-on system because, or we could, but it's just very expensive and adds a lot of complexity. So we'd rather just have all the rewards be the rewards and then deal with it on our own later, not through Kickstarter. Great question, Daniel. Thank you. I know those pins are awesome, and yeah. I also want a lot of them. Lauren was talking earlier on Facebook how she wants to get a tattoo of the Sensitive Badass design, which was by Megan Murphy at Why Not, and it's just so great.
Yeah.
I totally understand wanting them, more of them, and we're so excited to finally get in on this enamel pin craze.
Yay!
That has been flooding the nation.
We're so excited that we could do all these cool things for the Kickstarter.
Yeah, no, it's so fun to finally be able to make new stuff because of the Kickstarter.
Yeah.
It's a real awesome time.
Woo, woo, woo.
Is everybody still okay? Hi, everybody.
And thanks to everyone who made it fund already. We're so excited. We're on to stretch goals.
Mm-hmm.
I'm enjoying this. It's very warm.
Yeah.
It's great. Yes.
Camera's a lot closer than it usually is, so it's just like, hi, me.
Hello.
I'm going to make this smaller so it's less distracting.
Okay.
There we go.
Ooh.
I don't need to see me that close.
Yay.
Yeah. Let's do some songs.
Great. Let's do it.
This new song that we're about to play was heavily requested on Facebook. We are dedicating the song to Rose from T. Perrin Mitchell and also to Claire. Thank you for requesting the song. This is a new one. I wrote a little bit about this in a Kickstarter update, but this song was inspired by some rage that I felt about getting some messages from people when we sent out a slightly political message. We said to vote, and then we talked a little bit about who we didn't want to be elected right before the election, and then we got a few replies from people who told us very condescendingly that we had made a mistake by going political, which is a bummer, because I don't like being told what to do.
Nope.
And I also don't like being suddenly realizing that people don't realize how we feel about specifically the politics of believing humans are humans.
Yay.
in the context of LGBTQ community, just as the most obvious one, as a thing that we are very vocally, anyway. Hi, everybody. So, we were real pissed, and so we wrote a song about how it made us feel, and that's what this song is. Check out that update for a very much more eloquent version of that rambling that I just did. I talk fast so I don't get mad.
Now I'm small and I'm excited at looking at how small I am. Okay, here we go.
I let things bother me that I shouldn't let bother me, and I feel sorry like I should be stronger. I know I shouldn't listen to the insults or the heckles, but I listen and they all stick with me longer. My friend Michael Bain told me this is because we're evolved to remember the things that endanger us. If I was an animal searching for food, I would always be vigilant for things that are dangerous. So if I'm in real life or reading the comments, I'll always remember those who crossed the line. Not all the wonderful women and children who tell us we've helped them by speaking our mind. If it is negative, I'll memorize it fast, 'cause I am sensitive, not just a badass. I am sensitive. I am a badass. I act like I'm cocky. I have a persona, 'cause I don't wanna seem like I'm open for feedback. But that's just because I internalize everything that I should redact. I don't know if it's clear that that's just who I have.
That one.
Yeah.
T. Perry Mitchell, Claire, everybody, you're all the best. You're all sensitive badasses.
Yeah.
And we are very happy that we were able to write that song. And we got some really wonderful responses on Kickstarter to my story about it. It made me feel happy and validated. Darn you, internet.
I love that feeling.
Yay, checking in with the chat.
Chat.
Yeah. We have a question, Aubrey. There's a question for you from the Lauren.
Lauren
Zell.
Yeah.
Love your hair. Did you dye it yourself or have someone do it for you? Do you remember what brand and color the dye was? Aubrey, the people want to emulate your hair. What are your tips?
Okay, I did it myself. And I made it. I bleached it a whole lot. And that was so many chemicals. And then this color is hot pink. And it comes in a box that's gold and black and says argan oil on it. Is that helpful? Does that help? Does anybody need this? And
yeah.
That's why you were walking away?
I just left.
Yeah. But thank you. I really like the way it came out, and I'm digging this color.
Yeah, I think it looks great.
Thank you.
Oh, that was one thing we wanted to talk about. We promised people we would answer this question. Yesterday, we did this photo shoot.
Yeah!
With a woman named Beth Olson.
Kickstarter photo shoot.
Yeah, and it was, you know, it's a thing for promotion for the next album. And, oh boy, was it ever fun.
It was.
I was going to pull this up on the computer, but I forgot. But I will show you here. This is a little test shot of what the Kickstarter photos are going to, or I mean, album photos, I guess, yeah. Are going to look like.
Hooray! Do you see us?
Can you see it?
Can you see it?
Can you see it?
Can you see it? I like all the reflections.
There's so many reflections. Things are reflected into each other. It didn't turn out that well. But I can tweet it.
Awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, it was really fun. Aubrey, tell them about it a little bit.
Okay, so we're doing... It's a spaced theme shoot, and we're going to be floating in space with the magic of photography. And science.
And we were in zero gravity to film it. Just
that
in her basement.
Also that. Yeah. They just special zero gravity basement room that we were in. And we had a lot of fun doing our hair and makeup. And
I spent an hour and a half in hair and makeup.
Yeah. It was a lot of fun. We don't do that very often. Maybe ever. It was really fun. Yeah.
You can check out that photo on twitter.com/theDoubleClicks, where I just tweeted it. So you can actually see it. Sorry, it was blurry on my double reflection on the TV.
Yeah.
But thanks to the Kickstarter, we were able to do that. Kind of our first like big artsy photo shoot, which is a thing that bands do all the time.
Are we a band now?
I think we're a band now.
Hey!
I think we're officially a band. It's very exciting. What a good day.
Yeah.
It was really cool and fun.
Yes.
And another great use for our astronaut jumpsuits that we own now.
Yeah.
Gotta figure out how to use those as much as possible.
All the time.
Let's do another song.
Sweet.
This song was requested by Craig Steffen and a whole bunch of other people who had it. It's just a veritable campaign to bring back this old song. Which is called Uncle Geek's House. We wrote it for our uncle's birthday. He is a wonderful guy who got us into nerd stuff back in the days before the internet was there to get you into nerd stuff. And I remember playing Risk on a laptop that he set me up in his house. He had this very old, it wasn't even a Dell, it was some other thing that he had built. And I would play Risk on it just because having a computer was fun and important and a fun thing we'd do together. And then he'd hook up Ethernet cables and string them all across the floor and around the... door jams and stuff, because that's what you had to do if you wanted to use the internet. Kids, like some imaginary 5-year-olds are watching this, like, what's an Ethernet? I've learned something. But anyway, this is a song about Uncle Geek, who's a great guy. Where we all get high at 3:14. We don't have to go on camping trips. We can stay inside and read. Come with me to Uncle Geek's house, where the floors are cable.
and the food is ones and does. When we're with our Uncle Geek, we know that being cool means being brainy. Books are great and code is good, and fun isn't ruined if it is rainy. When we get to Uncle Geek's house, he'll be waiting for us to arrive. He'll first give us a great big hug and then a password for the Wi-Fi.
Talk about this every time about something that we're gonna add. We never do it.
I never will.
Nope. Now some more water.
Yay! All these people talking about Uncle Geeks, being Uncle Geeks, having Uncle Geeks.
Awesome.
Oh, good. We've got a 7-year-old.
Hello.
Named Poppy. Hi, Poppy.
Hey.
Ask your family to explain to you what an Ethernet cable is when you're old enough. Yeah, I have an uncle like that. He taught me D&D.
Nice.
Internet ding. Yay, thank you. Oh, yes, one thing that we like to mention is if you take some screenshots of the show, please share them with us. We can use them in the future, and we really appreciate it. Okay.
Hashtag DoubleClicksLive.
Hashtag DoubleClicksLive. Whew. This is fun. We're having fun. It's been a long day, and it has been a long week. It's all good.
Yeah.
You like my Star Wars shirt?
I love your Star Wars.
Rich tried to get rid of a box of t-shirts, and I kept them all.
Good work.
So now I'm rich.
Yeah.
Star Wars. Rich with t-shirts. Heyo. Sorry. This next song is a new song that we debuted on this live stream, actually, a few months ago. And now is a music video called Women Know Math. You can go to womenknowmath.com. I made painstakingly spend hours of work making a website for it. Was that necessary? I don't know. But my favorite part about it is that the song video has every lyric illustrated by a different woman or non-binary artist. And on the website, you can see all the art and then also information about each artist right next to the picture.
Yeah.
So you're like, who drew that great thing? And then you find out.
Check it out. It's so good. It's a great website. womenknowmath.com. womenknowmath.com. That's a gift.
This is so good with this.
Right? It feels very like that's what needed to happen was to wear a lab coat in front of math.
Aubrey, I don't disagree. That was my pop song. All right, so check out this song as we play it right now. This is a song about gender problems and so on.
My dress is muddy. My skin is bad. I'll call you buddy. I sort of want to be a dad. And I'm not curvy. I'm not slim. I don't wear makeup at home, on planes, or at the gym. And I'm not weak, and I'm not strong. I cry often. If you know the words, then sing along. I am a woman. None of these things disqualify me. I hear a lot of voices saying I'm doing it wrong, but please just try me. I like being a lady, and I don't need of what someone thinks that means. Though it might help you know just what to do with me. And you say in turn that would help me succeed. Who cares? crush on ladies. I crush on dudes. It is a sex crime to hack someone and share their nudes. Gender's performance. It isn't binary or real. If you don't like that, I do not care. You'll have to deal. You gave us dolls and then you told us they were dumb. You told us we'd get hurt if we had too much fun. You see the problem. Women know math. You can't tell us to do a thing, and then when we do it, laugh. Boys will be boys is a disgrace. And though you tell me things are changing, I am not willing to wait, 'cause it's a problem all around the world. Everyday people are punished for just being girls. No fair. I am a woman, and I'm doing it right. I am no matter what I do. I have pants and hair and dirt, and I am not here to please you. I have goals and plans and dreams, and I am not here to please you. I have talents, strengths, and words, and I am not here to please you.
Math. The song I didn't even say was requested by a bunch of people, including Rachel Ripley. Thank you for requesting that song. I'm feeling very happy with the reception to that.
Yes.
And I had a really good time. Did an interview with the Mary Sue website. A person.
The website didn't talk to you?
No. A person who writes for the Mary Sue website. Okay. I'll be honest. It wasn't the whole website.
Thank you for your honesty.
You're welcome. And we got to talk about that, and it was fun. And I got really angry and learned some stuff about myself.
Yay!
So that just goes to show you, nobody knows anything, and we're all going to die. Wait. we're all learning.
We're learning.
Speaking of that, positive messages, a four-year-old named Lillian is watching.
Hi, Lillian!
Thank you for watching. Oh, do we have something cool that a kid would like that we can hold in front of the screen to make us look fun? Look!
It's a little vampire.
Whee! Oh, speaking of the little vampire, actually, our friend Rebecca Hicks is currently kickstarting a project called The Little Vampires.
Are Confused About Bats.
Are Confused About Bats. It's a kid's book.
About
bats and the actual real facts. And yes, it's really great because she's... It's both, like, a funny kid's book and a great cartoon, and also, like, there's a lot of science and misconceptions, and that's just sort of the whole world, and what a great time to learn about that as a kid, reading a kid's book. There's a link to that Kickstarter in the description, because we suspected we might talk about it. Yay! Look at the little vampire! He's so happy!
Bye, little vampire!
Bye, little vampire! Where'd he go? All right. We're gonna play one more song, and then call in our very special guest.
Yeah.
Oh, she hid behind Mom.
Oh,
sorry.
Sorry, Lillian.
Cool. I'm having such a good time. I think the thing that's distracting is this. I just want to see it. I want to read it. And so I'm looking into the screen and it's there and I'm like...
You're doing calculations.
Uh-huh. Cylinder. Area of a cylinder. Interesting. but let's do music.
And okay.
This song... Oldie but a goodie. was requested by Freddie and a whole bunch of other people. It's a song we wrote about Wonder Woman, but really, especially more and more as the days wear on, it's a song about anybody who is persevering even when, despite opposition.
Yes.
And people who tell you that the way you think is wrong. You just keep going. So, song about all those things. Did you tune it?
No.
Oh.
It's just very in tune.
Good work, cello. Good work, cello.
Good work, cello.
Leaving home for the first time. You never knew that deals could be so dirty. You never thought.
watch you in wonder.
Everybody, that was nice. That was a special it's a special edition of Angela Plays Music Slowly When She's Happy.
Yeah.
Kind of easy to analyze. It's fun.
It's great.
All right, we are going to
call in the special guest.
Call in the special guest.
Special guest, special guest, special guest, special guest, special guest.
Our special guest is a good friend, a very funny comedian and writer, and a screenwriter and joke writer and podcaster and creator of shows.
Nope.
There it is. And his name is Joseph Scrimshaw, and he'll be with us in just a minute. His website is josephscrimshaw.com, and he is game is being a rad guy. Joseph, can you hear us? Joseph, can Joseph. We hear you? Joseph.
Did I go away?
Oh, there you are. Yay! Hi, Joseph!
Yay. Hi. How are you?
We're doing so good. How are you?
Good. My computer is telling me that there's an error, but I can hear you and see you, so my computer is just wrong.
It looks like the people can hear you and see you too. Let me make sure.
Yay. Hello, people. Hello, children and adults.
We're all real.
Yes.
Does it feel like you're talking on people who are talking to you on an old-timey telephone?
It really does.
Oh, hello? Joseph's on the line.
Hello.
Joseph.
Hello. This feels like talking to my grandmother a long, long time ago. Hello.
Joseph, we have a couple questions that we ask every guest on the show, and I think you've probably answered
them. Oh, awesome.
But let's just make sure that we know. First of all, Joseph Scrimshaw, if you could be any kind of bird in the world, what would be the best thing about being a bird?
I would want to be a robin, because that would be like the superhero Robin.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the best thing about being a bird is that birds can just suddenly fly away from any interaction, and that is not considered rude, because that's just what birds do.
Yes.
So I think that would be pretty awesome to just be like, this this interaction is no longer for me, and then you just fly away.
That's so good.
Flap, flap, flap.
That question teaches me so much about everybody we ask it to, and that is no exception. I love it. Question number two, if you could name a galaxy, what would you name it?
Ooh, name a galaxy?
Yeah.
I would name it a Star Wars galaxy.
Yeah.
Then people would just be confused about what exactly does that mean.
Yeah. That's great. Is Star Wars Galaxy a game?
I'm sure it is.
Yeah. Sorry, I didn't. I assumed that you would know. I'm excited. So Joseph, before I know you are going to read some amazing stuff for us, but before we do that, I would just want, for anybody who doesn't know you, for you to tell us what your relationship is with Star Wars as a person. Can you tell us? Can you hear us?
Is there an error?
Joseph.
Relationship. I hope that Star Wars loves me as much as I love Star Wars. But it has meant a lot to me since I was a very, very small little human being, and now I host a Star Wars podcast called Force Center, so I can actually, for work, get all the books and read them and talk about them, and I talked about Star Wars last night for 3 hours straight, and it was great.
Wow.
Professionally.
Yeah.
That's so awesome. And you have some Star Wars to share with us now, is this true?
I do. So this is a thing that I wrote a long time ago, because I like Star Wars a lot, and I like Twitter a lot, and I am kind of obsessed with both of them. So I decided to combine them, and I wrote a bit that was telling the story of Star Wars Episode IV, A New Hope, through the Twitter feed of the main characters. And I wrote this a long time ago, and when I looked at it, I realized that it needed a little bit of updating, so I updated it a little bit. Some of it's still a little old technology-wise, but I think it is pretty dated. Shall I begin?
Please.
Excellent. Here we go. Star Wars Episode 4, A New Hope. Twitter feeds of the main characters. Tweet from Luke Skywalker. Just looked at twin sons and daydreamed about having an epic destiny. Eyes hurt. Need to stop looking directly into twin sons. LOL. Tweet from Princess Leia to Obi-Wan Kenobi. I need your help destroying the Death Star. Tweet from Princess Leia to Obi-Wan Kenobi. Crap. That was supposed to be a direct message. Crap. Tweet from Darth Vader. About to retrieve stolen Death Star plans and get my evil on. Sent from my Verizon chest unit. Tweet from manager of General Goods Store in Tashi Station. Luke, your power converters are in. Are you going to pick them up? Tweet from C-3PO. I am C-3PO. This is my first tweet. Oh my. I'm not sure I get how this works. Ha ha. I understand there is a limit on the number of Tweet from old Ben Kenobi to Luke Skywalker. I think I just called you. I didn't mean to. I had my phone in my robes and I accidentally force dialed you. Reply from Luke Skywalker. LOL. Wait, what is the force? Reply from old Ben Kenobi. It's a mystical energy field that binds and penetrates everybody. That didn't come out right. Come to my hut. Tweet from Imperial Stormtroopers. Tatooine peeps, we're looking for these droids. We can't find them. Please help us in our search by backing our Kickstarter now. Thank you. Tweet from Han Solo. There are no words in this tweet. It is just a selfie that Han took of himself in the cantina bathroom. Very sexy. Tweet from Chewbacca. Roar! Smiley face. Tweet from Han Solo. I just shot Greedo. He didn't even have a chance to get off his shot. If anyone tells you he shot first, they're liars.
Yes.
Tweet from Darth Vader. Thread. So I blew up Alderaan, a little bummed about being so mean to Princess Leia. She looks and acts just like my wife. Second tweet from Darth Vader. And she's about the right age to be my daughter. Maybe I should look into that. Third tweet from Darth Vader. Screw it. I'm going to take a bath. Sent from my Verizon meditation Bacta tank. Yeah. Tweet from Han Solo. Alderaan is not here. Google Maps can suck my Corellian butt. Tweet from manager of General Goods Store in Tashi Station. Luke, your power converters are in. Are you going to pick them up? Reply from Luke Skywalker. Can't. Busy. Being sucked into giant armadillo space station. Tweet from Luke Skywalker. Sorry, meant armored space station. Stupid autocorrect. Tweet from Han Solo. Hey, at Emperor _ Palpatine, I'm in your space station shooting your dudes. Tweet from Darth Vader. About to fight Obi-Wan. Last time we were spinning through the air and stuff. Now we look like 80-year-olds doing a polka with glow sticks. Sad. I wrote the sad thing a long time ago, and then it became more real, which is sad. Tweet from Luke Skywalker. Just saw Obi-Wan die. Leia is comforting me, even though she just saw her whole planet explode. Oh, I think I understand what privilege is now. Tweet from General Dodonna of the Rebel Alliance. Time it took the Empire to build the Death Star. 19 years. Time it took the Rebel Alliance to find fatal flaw. 2 minutes. Hashtag fail. Tweet from Luke Skywalker. Flying around trying to blow up a space station before it kills everyone. Probably shouldn't be tweeting right now. Tweet from Darth Vader. Flying in my spaceship shooting down rebels. Could have stayed at home and choked the pilots with my mind. WTF. Sent from my Verizon Twin Ion Engine Advanced X-1 prototype starship. Yeah. Tweet from Luke Skywalker. Proton torpedoes in the exhaust port shaft with the force for the win! Woo! Tweet from Princess Leia. About to give the guys medals for blowing up the Death Star. Not giving one to Chewbacca. Kind of feel like a jerk about that. Shrugging emoji. Tweet from Chewbacca. Roar! Sad face. Sorry, that's the story. Tweet from Luke Skywalker. Drank blue milk, met new friends, blew up a big dumb space station, and started taking How to Be a Jedi 101. Pretty epic day for a farm boy. Tweet from manager of General Goods Store in Tashi Station. Luke, we sold your power converters to someone else. Thanks for being a really bad bleeping customer, Skywalker.
Yay!
I like. I really like the addition of Thread as an evil person thing. I'm a big fan. Thank you.
Darth Vader would absolutely thread his thoughts. Almost all of his tweets would be threaded.
Yes. Absolutely.
And it would announce at the top.
Oh, big time. Let's talk about space game theory.
It's never time for game theory.
No. Joseph Scrimshaw, obviously everyone loves you now. I want to plug one thing for you because it has really, I've started driving a lot. And so I started listening to podcasts again. And your podcast, Obsessed, not just because I've been on it like four times, is an amazing podcast. And it just, it's so many different people from different parts of life and talking about the things that are they're obsessed with. And like not just telling you about the thing, but also a really deep dive on like how that affects who they are as a person. And it is amazing podcast. You can learn about like criminology. You can learn, I talk about coloring books. Anyway.
There's a new one on John Waters movies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's my plug to you, Joseph. Do you think you'll listen to Obsessed with Joseph Scrimshaw?
I'm going to go back and listen to my podcast. I'm going to edit myself out and just listen to the responses from my guests.
I do not think that will be as good. Joseph, what else would you like to tell people about?
Well, you can go to my website, josephscrimshaw.com, for any updates on any live shows I'm doing, all that kind of thing. Mm-hmm. I have a couple of albums. I have a Star Wars album. I have an album called Flawfest that is a comedy and music album. And the DoubleClicks have a song on that about eggs, which is great. Obsessed. Got a couple new episodes coming out soon. And then my Star Wars podcast, Force Center. You can just Google Force Center and you'll find either my Star Wars podcast or a gym in Sweden that really helps you get buff.
Yeah.
So check out either of those four centers.
Channel your force into your center. I get it. That's great.
I have no idea what force center might actually mean in Swedish, but I'll look into it someday.
I hope you never do. Joseph,
that is
so
my
much
promise.
For being on our show. We are. It's just so fun to see you again. We just did some shows together in the Pacific Northwest. It was super fun.
Yeah, I know. It's really weird. I have this like sense memory of hearing the songs and pacing backstage. And now it's weird to be sitting in my home with an evening beverage and hearing them on the magic of the internet.
Yeah, it's pretty weird. And we're not wearing a pizza costume backstage during your show.
It's weird. Yeah, but you should wear the pizza costume more. That it's amazing.
It's pretty great. I agree. Well, thank you so much, Joseph.
Thank you. And thanks for everybody in the chat. You're all wonderful people.
They are. They love you.
Yay!
It's blowing up. It's blowing up with joy and ha-has.
Good. Ha-ha. Thanks, Internet.
Bye.
Joseph Scrimshaw.
Yay!
Yay!
Everybody go to josephscrimshaw.com.
Josephscrimshaw.com.
We laughed so hard. We need to take a breath.
I know. I can't breathe anymore.
Looking at the chat. Making sure there's no questions. Boop, 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 doop, doop, doop. Yeah.
Yay! Okay, it's all going well. How are you? Did we tell you that we're kickstarting our album? And if you want, you can go to Kickstarter and the link's in the description, support our album, and then you will have our album. If you pre-order the album on Kickstarter, you'll get it before anybody else does, at least by a day, usually longer than that. And you'll also help us reach some stretch goals that we're working on, including adding live drums to the album and President Snake's musical and the creation of a new dinosaur sticker. So if you would like to head over there, just a little bit, but there's also some amazing rewards at the higher levels. Anything you can do to support is really helpful to us. And
or share it with your friends.
Or share
it
with your friends. That's super great.
It'd be
or
really
just
helpful.
Watch the music or the Kickstarter pitch video. I'm so proud of it. It's 54 seconds long.
Yeah.
Because I love a short Kickstarter video. And we just had such a good time filming it. And Aubrey did a great job lighting it.
Oh, thank you.
We used this very backdrop.
Yeah. You may remember it if you've already seen the video.
And it was a good old time. So,
yeah.
It's an honor And we are constantly reminded of the things that we are able to do just because folks like you are willing to help us crowdfund our work. So thank you so much. It means that we can speak our mind. It means that we can make the stuff we want to make. It means that we don't have to spend all our time trying to fit into the box that would get us a record label deal or on the stage at a standard music venue or any of these other things that the music industry used to be made of that it isn't made of anymore. So it means a lot to us, and it's really, really amazing that we've already made $42,000 on the Kickstarter. Thanks to you. You've raised that money. We can do so much cool stuff with that. And that's great. It's so cool.
It's so cool. We're so excited.
Yeah. There's a link in the description here if you want to go back it. We put a little tracker on it so we can see how many of the awesome DoubleClicks Live community people go and back the Kickstarter using that link. That's cool. I don't know what that's going to do, but
that's a cool thing.
Analytics are fun. David Carroll knows what I'm talking about.
Hey!
Yeah. So let's, we talked about, Rebecca Hicks in the beginning of the Kickstarter. One of the really cool things about us and our job and the fact that we are crowdfunded so we can participate in all kinds of communities, not just like the music world, is that we get an opportunity to meet all these amazing artists, who, and entertainers and performers and, creators that do all kinds of things. And one of these people is named Kayla Cagan. She's probably the greatest person on the planet. We met Kayla and her husband Josh and have worked with them on various projects over the past like 5 years. We're going to do this first. We'll do this now. Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Kayla's debut novel is coming out in 2 weeks. It's called Piper Parish. And I got a chance to read an advanced copy of it. And it's just great, and it is really a book we need right now. It's like set in high school. It's sort of like the young adult genre of books, but I think it is a book for everybody, and it has this strong message coming out of it, just not like it's preachy or anything, but this strong feeling that it gives you of like, I want to make something now, and I want to absorb art of other people and create my own art and be a better friend and wear cool clothes that I make myself. And it's really great. And I got the opportunity to interview Kayla about her book for a project that we're working on called You Should Write a Song About That, where we interview an entertaining person about something they like, and then we write a song about our conversation. And I wrote a song about Kayla's book and the conversation that we had about the book, and about creation and making stuff, and how it is such a good combat to both internal and external depression and roadblocks. And we're gonna play a song right now.
Yeah!
A lot of you on the Facebook page requested surprise new song, which was very sneaky of you. And that's so we decided we had to have the song ready for right now.
Yeah.
So let's play a brand new song.
Woo! Brand new song. It's time for brand new song.
Share the genius in your heart is you.
get lost in the world, do not be afraid. Go and fill up the world with all the things you've made. You've got to find a way around to be the person you'll become. They say time changes things, but actually you'll be the one who changes them. Now is the time for fearlessness. Getting it right is not the point if you persevere. Art is the gift of truth. Art is the gift of you. Art is the gift of reminding everyone the reason we are here. Now is the time. Now is the time. Now is the time.
Yay! New song! Yeah, no, that'll be really good once we know how it goes. But I was pretty happy with that.
I was very happy.
Thank you guys for letting us try out a new song.
New song.
That song is called Now's the Time, Piper Parish.
Yeah.
And
you can pre-order the book right now.
Yes. And maybe you should. I'm not saying, okay, or put it on your calendar to go get it at the library or get it for school. It's just a lot of books exist in the world, but this one made me feel things. And I feel like if we all pre-order it, then it will chart, and then everyone will know it's a really good book,
yeah.
And then they will buy it. It's like super legit, and I really enjoy this book a great deal. And it's got a cool cover, and it's got art. And if you're into Andy Warhol as a person or as a maybe problematic fave that a high schooler could have. It's a cool story about that too, and just sort of have, all right, I'm not going to talk too much about the plot. I want you to read it, but it's a great book.
Yeah.
Now, let's do another old song.
Ooh.
How about that?
Sounds great.
We're going to do this song now. This is a song that Aubrey sings.
It is.
Because Lauren requested it, and Lauren was right. Lauren has good bit ideas.
Hey!
That's why she's our top consultant on the show. A link to the book is in the description of the video. Oh, gosh. Thank you, Flail Squared. Lauren's the best. Oh, my gosh. Speaking of Lauren, other Lauren, Flail Squared, in the chat right now, if you're into maybe backing our Kickstarter, Lauren made Doubleclicks themed cat beds.
That's right.
And they're going to be amazing. They're Yay. Cat cubes. With a little heart opening that says, I love you like a burrito on the inside. Because Lauren says to her cat, I love you like a burrito, which is super cute. And it says the Doubleclicks on the top. And just the fact that that exists makes me happy. But if you're into that, you should check it out. All right, let's do some more songs.
More songs. Yeah.
This song features Maximilian the Cat Keyboard as my part, and primarily Aubrey here.
I will be singing most
on the
of
ones
this.
And twos.
One, two.
One being drinking water.
Mm-hmm. Two being singing.
Two being singing.
Here we go.
Sometimes I think that I really might love you. Sometimes I write you a couplet or two. And they're nice, but I find when you're on my mind that there's something else I'm supposed to do. Sometimes when I am behind on a project, that day you're of my affection, the object
Then I watch the Twilight Zone. I play games on my phone, 'cause there's something else I'm supposed to do. Sometimes I write you a letter, my dear. I don't know your address, but if you want to come get it, it's here. Sometimes I find my own thoughts alarming when I think that your faults could be sort of charming. Our love isn't fate, it's what I do to procrastinate when there's something else I'm supposed to do. I really should get to work. It's due tomorrow. I'm gonna be in trouble. I think of what it would be like with you as my husband and me as your wife. Then I get back to work because you are a jerk and there's something else I'm supposed to do.
While that's a song about not creating and procrastinating.
Yeah.
Woo.
It's been a while.
Yeah.
Oh boy. What's going on? We got two more songs. On the playlist. It's gonna be fun. There's so many people here tonight. This is awesome.
Thanks for joining us, everyone.
If you're enjoying the show, please give a thumbs up to the video because that is helpful. And
we enjoy it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's do this song.
Yeah.
Oh, I can take these off now.
Yeah, you can. You no longer have to listen to yourself in the microphone.
Ooh, what is the name of the microphone we're using? That's a cue from the chat.
A cue from the crypt. This is a AKG C214. That is what it is.
Thanks for performing for us. You're welcome. Thanks for listening.
We're having a great time.
This is great. I'm loving it. Do you think I can't pull it?
No, I don't think so.
Okay. This is a cover that was requested by Tabletop Owlbear, everybody's favorite Australian internet geek and sundry fan.
Yay!
Actually, I have a couple favorites now that I think of it. But he's the tallest. who we met at Gen Con, remember?
Yes.
Yeah,
that was fun.
It's really cool to, now that we've been in this community for 6 years, it's like, I have one coworker, but I have a whole big community of people that I get to see when I go to work, like once a year. It's cool. And some of you get to know each other, which is so fun. Okay, here we go. This looks familiar, vaguely familiar, almost unreal, yet it's too soon to feel yet. My soul, and yet so far away.
heart, heaven, heart, space, or have I found my place? You can't just visit, but I plan to stay. I'm going to go back there someday. I'm going to go back there someday.
Progressing the song. As a song from the Muppet movie that Gonzo sings. But he only sings it once in the movie, and I've sang it twice in like the movie of my life, of the highlight reel of my life, I think. Because I sang it at your senior concert.
Oh, yeah.
And at your wedding. I feel like both of those scenes are going to be in the whatever.
In my movie of my life.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, take that, Gonzo. What's happening? I'm scared.
Song means a lot to us. We really enjoy it. Thanks for requesting it.
Yay! Look at all these happy people.
Yay!
Oh, yay! Tabletop Albert. Yeah. Cool. Alrighty. We just got one more song. Thank you for tuning in, everybody. We're the Doubleclicks. I think we talked about everything that we wanted to talk about. Please check out josephscrimshaw.com. We have so many friends who are making so much stuff, so we have so much stuff to tell you about, but check them out. My fiancé, Rich, has a Kickstarter right now for an amazing puzzle-solving tool. If you're a person into puzzles, here's the pitch for you. It's going to have 15 different code unlocking things on it, like, you know, your binary and your one with the flags.
Semaphore?
This guy, am I right? And a whole bunch of other stuff. So it'll have those for easy access when you're out on your puzzle hunts. And if you're not yet a big puzzle person, it will also have on the other side some tips. So you know when you're in the puzzle pint world or in some sort of escape room or code situation, like, oh, this looks like this kind of code. If it just sort of common knowledge or common tricks that you might not know about. Like, if it looks like a clock, it might be semaphore, because those things are frequently used to decode each other. Anyway, it's a cool code. It's called the Puzzle Key Ring, and it's only got a number of hours left on Kickstarter. Yeah. So if that sounds cool to you, check it out.
It's really cool. Check it out.
So many plugs. We have so many cool people making so much cool stuff. See? We're doing what Piper Parrish tells us to do, making things. Thank you, Kayla Cagan.
Yay!
We love you. Kayla Cagan one time consulted us on fashion. Remember that?
Yes.
We were like, we want fashion. And she was like, here are some cool ideas. And we were like, this is awesome. We're terrified of clothes.
Yep.
But you wear like the kind of like suits kind of stuff that she was putting together for you.
Yes.
A little bit these days.
Yes.
Aubrey just bought a tux.
I just bought a tux.
To wear on the cruise that we're about to be on, the Joco cruise. Yeah. Oh, yeah, we should talk about, we got the Joco cruise coming up. There's still a couple days if you want to come spend a bunch of money to see us play on the ocean. That'll be fun. If not, don't worry about it. But if you do go, it'll be fun.
Yes.
Then we also have a show in Portland coming up, and then we have a show in Alaska coming up, and we have a fourth thing. So check out our website. Let's do one more song. Thank you all so much for tuning in to the show.
Yeah. We have a great time.
Just making sure I didn't forget anything. This goes by so fast. Thank you for joining us. We're going to probably do a live stream on Kickstarter at some point. In the next few weeks, we're so busy that I don't know when, but stay tuned and find out more about that. This song was requested by Pavel Curtis and a bunch of other people. Thank you for requesting this song. It's a song about partying, which is this. This has been a party, but if metaphor, the cats in the song were friends on the internet, it'd be a song about that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Hit it.
I'm gonna tell you what you need to party right. right. It's the new craze, it's the way every night. Put your pants on and drive up to the party house and suddenly remember that you don't like going out. Yeah, you're still a weirdo. Well, imagine that. Here is your solution. Go and find the host's cat. Hanging with cats at parties. Party parties, it's the new movement. Why don't you join me? We don't want your judgment and we don't need your pity. This is where I wanna be. Hanging out with cats at parties. Walk into the party like, no thanks, I'll keep my coat. Ending conversations with a nice Taylor Swift quote and saying things like, I don't like local beer. Scanning every corner for the reason you are here. There is a cat, so I'm not technically alone now. Don't tell me to smile, I am in my comfort zone now. Yes, I'm having fun, I don't need a drink. This is way more comfortable than you probably think. Hanging with cats at parties. Party parties, it's the new movement. Why don't you join me? We don't want your judgment and we don't need your pity. This is where I wanna be. Hanging out with cats at parties. A cat is not a bigot or a sexist. A cat could care less if you even exist. Unless you're giving it treats, it will just stare at you. And that's the kind of friend I want. What can I do? Our numbers grow out of nowhere like mitosis. We're all slowly contracting toxoplasmosis. We don't need your shame, our life is better cause it's lame. And tonight's just about one thing. Hanging with cats at parties. Party parties, it's the new movement. Why don't you join me? We don't want your judgment and we don't need your pity. This is where I wanna be. Hanging out with cats at parties. Alright, sing along at home. Hanging out with cats at parties. One more time. Hanging out with cats at parties.
Push the button, Frank.
Thanks, everybody.